Welcome to Appleton North High School, the site for tonight's Fox Valley Association regular season finale. On the boys' side for the visiting Neenah Rockets and the host Appleton North Lightning, it's another USA Today Network Wisconsin digital live stream. I am Ricardo Arguello, hanging out as always with Brett Christopherson, bringing you the high-definition shots. That's Jim Rosandick. We call him Rosie. Again, all part of USA Today Network Wisconsin. And I know it's been a long time for you, Brett, but we went from November now to just, midway through February, maybe a little later in February, Brett, and now we're at the regular season finale on the boys' side, Brett, with the postseason right around the corner. And we have a couple teams, Brett, that really want to get off on a good last foot before the postseason.
Yeah, two teams, though, going in different directions, right? Neenah Rockets red hot. And Appleton North, a little bit of a skid here towards the end of the season. I think they've, lost four or five. We'll get to it in our game notes. But seedings are out, brackets are out, so both of these two teams know where their playoff path will go. But this was a good test for both squads, right? A good way for both teams to get ready for the postseason. And see how far they can go. I think, Ricardo, you both agree there's a lot of talent on both of these two teams that I think they can both make deep tournament runs. We saw Appleton North do it last year, of course. Neenah went all the way to the state tournament.
They did, Brett. And, again, that postseason starts next Tuesday with regional play. And we're expecting a good one here from Appleton North between the Rockets and the Lightning. Let's get to know the teams a little bit. I will start with Appleton North. Brett will follow with Neenah, all these notes put together every week so nicely by Brett. What do we know about Appleton North? Where they're 16, the Lightning are 16-7, 11-6 in the Fox Valley Association, coming off an 83-80 non-conference setback to Oconomowoc on Tuesday. That was at Oconomowoc. It was Appleton North, as Brett said, third straight loss for the Lightning, and it's fourth in the past five games. Four players scored in double figures for Appleton North, with Will Sweeney's 21 points leading the way against Oconomowoc. He was 5 of 12 overall, 4 of 9 from three-point range. He also added 5 boards. Nathan Ramos next with 18 points. He also grabbed 7 boards. Abraham Tamari finished with 14 points on 4 of 6 shooting. Sean Hansen chipped in with 10 points and 6 assists. Appleton North out-rebounded in that game, 33-21 defensively. Lightning came up with 11 steals and forced 23 turnovers. Now on the season, Sweeney, leading scorer for Appleton North at 14.3 points a game. He's shooting 52% overall, 47% from three-point range, and his 49 triples, they lead the team. He's also shooting 71% from the charity stripe. Now, Tamori is next at 13.8, shooting 48% overall, 40% from distance. His 47 three-pointers at second on the team. He's also hitting 63% from the free throw line. Grant Hardy, he's third at 10.7 points, shooting 38% overall, 33% from the three-point line, and 85% from the line. And Ramos, he's right there too, 9.8 points, shooting 38% overall, 28% from beyond the arc, 74% from the stripe. In rebounding, Hardy, Tamori, Ramos, they are at 5, 4.8 and 4.7 per game, respectively, and Ramos is 4.2 assists, are tops in that category. Team-wise, Appleton North, shooting 46% overall, 35% from three-point range, and 69% from the free-throw line. Opponents, they're shooting 43% overall against Appleton North, 33% from the three-point line, and opponents are also out-rebounding the Lightning, 28 to 27.5 per game. They're averaging 8.5 steals a game, and Appleton North overall averaging 68.2 points a game and allowing 59.3. Their next home game, that's against Kimberly. Playoffs, WIA Division I regional semifinal on March 1st. Tip-off scheduled for 7 o'clock. Brett, what can you tell me about the Rockets?
Yeah, Rockets, Ricardo, red hot. 16-7 overall, 12-5 in the Fox Valley Association. Winners of 8 straight, 12 of their last 13. Really playing their best ball at the right time. They're coming off a 65-52 victory over Oshkosh West last Friday. That was a Fox Valley Association matchup at the brand spanking new Neenah High School. Brady Corso, he had a huge night as he finished with 31 points on 10 of 17 shooting. That included a 4 of 8 showing from three-point range, 7 of 8 from the free throw line. He also grabbed 4 rebounds. Charlie Wunderlich added 10 points and 3 rebounds in the victory. Overall, 9 players scored for the Rockets, who shot 52% as a team and came up with 12 steals. For the season, Corso leads the way in scoring and an even 22 points per game. That ranks third in the FVA. Fantastic career, fantastic season. He's shooting 49% overall, 37% from beyond the arc, 91% from the free throw line. Wunderlich is next at 13.4 points. He's shooting 62% overall, 39% from three-point range. And Luke Young now, Ricardo, he's back. Remember he had that, is that a football injury, right, that carried into the basketball season for a stretch? Now he's back, big addition for the Rockets. He's third in scoring at 8.8 points through those 14 games that he has returned. He's shooting 59% overall, 74% from the stripe. Corso is the top rebounder at five boards per game. He's also the assist leader at 4.3 per game. As a team, Neenah shooting 51% overall, 36% from three-point range, 74% from the free throw line. Opponents are shooting 49% overall and 36% from three-point range. The Rockets also out-rebounding their opponents, 24.2 to 20.4 per game, and averaging 7.7 steals per game. Scoreboard, Neenah averaging 64.3 points per game overall and allowing 57. And up next for the Rockets, we'll talk about this throughout the webcast too, Ricardo, because I want to get your thoughts on the Fox Valley Association. A tad underseeded, I would say, on the boys' side when you compare what's going on in some of the other brackets. But anyway, up next for the Rockets, they're home against Eau Claire North. That's March 1st. WIA Division I Regional Semifinal tip-off is scheduled for 7 p.m. But great to be here for the regular season finale, our final regular season Varsity Game of the Week live stream. We're going to do boys and girls postseason play. Probably won't hit the girls' side till we hit sectionals. And we'll see if there's any good regional matchups in a regional final that we could maybe hit on the boys' side. We'll see how it all plays out. Depends on who wins, and we're kind of at the mercy of where these games will also be played as well. But some interesting, I thought, seedings on the boys' side when it comes to the Fox Valley Association. Seems like it's the HAL 9000, whatever you call that thing, maybe underselling the Fox Valley Association a tad. So we'll talk about that as we get going, because I definitely want to get your thoughts. Also want to thank Appleton North Athletic Director Jerry Kabuski, sitting right over there to our left. Great guy. Always rolls out the red carpet, make sure we're good to go. Great staff here at Appleton North, whether we're doing football, basketball games. So it's always great to come here. Great setup.
Great to be here after, you know, this past season, after not being here in regularity, I guess, in previous years.
Yeah, from the boys' side in particular, right? This is our third time seeing Appleton North boys here all at home. We've seen the Rockets once at home, once at Kimberly, now our third time here at Appleton North. So we're doing a pretty good job, I think, of spreading it out a little bit. Corso, we've been streaming a lot of fantastic girls games as well. That's going to be an interesting playoff on the girls' side. Could we see a Neenah Hortonville sectional championship game again? Will the Kimberly Papermakers advance? Will a team like Appleton North on the girls' side playing some pretty good basketball here as of late as well? Could they make a tournament run? And how about on the boys' side? How about the Patriots, Appleton East? They've been playing good basketball as well.
They have been. They're going to be a team to watch. I think you talked about the low seeds. I think they got it just boggles my mind to this day that Fox Valley Association is not respected enough to be giving a seeds more aligned with how strong their conference is.
I thought Appleton East, I think they're on a 7-game winning streak, right? Overall, of course, Joey LaChapelle, the conference's leading scorer. We'll see how it all plays out here in these weeks to come. But thanks to our season sponsors, Cellcom ETS Performance and Cooney's Embroidery and Sportswear. Stay connected to who and what matters most with Cellcom's unlimited data starting as low as $25 a month per line. Visit Cellcom.com for details. ETS Performance, the leading provider of sports performance training for athletes across the Midwest and Northeast Wisconsin. ETS provides a customized approach to strength, speed, and injury prevention training for athletes of all sports ages 8 and up. Train like the pros and take your performance to the next level. Visit ETSperformance.com to schedule your free athlete evaluation today at the ETS location nearest you. And I know they have one in Appleton and one in the Green Bay area. Finally, get your team, club, or business name out there with Cooney's Embroidery and Sportswear. They customize products specifically to fit their customers' needs. Delivery service is available. Contact them today at 920-731-0922 or send them an email at Cooney's, COONEYS0922 at sbcglobal.net. And I appreciate everybody's patience The JV game ran a little bit long, and then they had a real nice senior night ceremony where they got the seniors on Appleton North, Ricardo, really some nice gifts, some customized basketballs,
yeah.
Kind of in a trophy box. So had to get the festivities out of the way, I guess, if you want to say it like that. But we're ready to go here at Appleton North High School. A few more seconds remaining until our national anthem, and then we'll meet the starting five for both squads.
All right, getting ready for the starting lineups for tonight's game. Appleton North hosting Neenah.
We will begin with the visiting Neenah Rockets.
For the Rockets, at one forward, 6'3" senior Justin Jansen. At the other forward, 6'2" junior forward Luke Young, and three guards, 5'11" sophomore Nick Schultz, 6'1" senior Brady Corso, and 6'1" senior Charlie Wunderlich.
Ricardo, looking at the Appleton North starting five, looks like head coach seniors. Chris Kelly going to go with all seniors to start tonight's game here on Senior Night. I thought those we mentioned they had a nice ceremony presentation for Appleton North, but I thought it was a nice touch to recognize the Neenah seniors here
yeah.
as well. Very nicely done by Appleton North. Nice crowd here in a Thursday night. Ricardo, I can't believe the girls' postseason's underway, and I can't believe we're here at the regular season finale already for the boys. Where did the time go?
Brett, it goes by quick, and boy, before you know it.
The older you get, right?
Not just that. It'll be springtime, and we'll be, looking at the spring slate. For me, anyway, softball and baseball and track. The state track and field meet will be here before I know it.
Spring for me is starting to get things in order for the fall again, and then, of course, working on the Northeast Wisconsin High School Sports Awards show.
I'm still going to try to get you to maybe do a softball game, Brett.
We'll see. We'll see how it goes. I'm willing to talk. I'm willing to discuss.
You're willing to negotiate.
We need a center field cam. If anybody's got one out there for us, let us know. Did you announce the starting five?
I was going to do it right now.
Okay.
Starting senior lineup for Appleton North, Braden Hetchel, 6-foot senior.
Heckel.
Oh, it is Heckel. Okay.
Heckel, yep.
Luke Kreitzer, 5'10" senior. All seniors, I should say. Larson Hager, 6'3". Number 20. Will Gilboa. I had to wait for them to pronounce it for me, Brett. 6'1". And then rounding out the starting lineup, Nathan Stanislavski.
Nice touch by Chris Kellett. Go with an all-senior lineup to start this game. Hey, everything's kind of in place, right? So you have a little fun, but I'm guessing once the ball is tipped, then it gets serious again, right? You know, if you're the Rockets, either team, you don't want to go into postseason play with an L. Rockets want to keep that hot streak going. 12 of the last 13 winners. Appleton North wants to reverse the trend here. Definitely skidding here as of late. Want to enter tournament play on a good note as well. And the Appleton North wins the tip, and we are underway.
Stanislavski getting a nice cheer from the student section, winning that tip.
Gonna let one fly right away.
Look at the hustle.
Yeah, they're diving for it.
Nice rebound by Kreitzer. Luke, as we know, had a nice season for Ed as a starting quarterback.
Did indeed. Nice little back cut there along the baseline. Couldn't get it to fall. Corso with the rebound. Three from the top. Looks good, and it is for Justin Jansen.
Nice stroke there, Brett, from Jansen. Rockets up 3-0. Just underway here at Appleton North High School near the 17-minute mark. FBA regular season finale for these two boys' teams.
Yeah, the last time these two teams met, that was back on January 27th at Neenah High School. Well, Rockets winning that one 57-37. Good baseline defense there.
Did that kind of get them on their win streak, or was that midway through their little streak they got going here?
I'll only check the season schedule here. In a second, I can answer that. That was kind of the second game. They had beaten, Kakana right before that, 63-54. Actually, I checked that. I'm going to go back to January 5th. It was a victory over Appleton West. And then it's been W's except for a loss to Fond du Lac ever since. But that was definitely beating Appleton North was in that stretch. Brady Corso led the Rockets in that one with 16 points. He also finished with 7 assists, 6 rebounds. Luke Young added 14 points and 11 rebounds. Charlie Wunderlich, he chipped in with 14 points on 7 of 10 shooting. Sean Hansen was the top scorer in that game for Appleton North with just 8 points. The Lightning Ricardo shot just 36% overall. 3 of 18 from 3-point range. And I want to talk about that. I have that in the game notes too. We'll see when Appleton North decides to kind of put its regular starting five back on the floor to begin this game. But three-point shoot, they love to shoot the three, and it's kind of as the three ball goes, so go the Lightning. And right lately, anyway, really been struggling with that three-point shot.
Schultz for Neenah. There's Jansen again.
Yeah, he's feeling it. Oh, rims out.
Second rebound for Kreitzer. Oh, inside to Stanislavski, Brett.
Oh, I think he had the move initially before spinning the other way, right? Oh, nice bounce pass. Little shot fake for Young, and that's a beautiful feed from Corso. Boy, if you're Lee Robus, nice to have Luke Young back, right? 6'2 junior forward. He's number 5 for the Rockets. Missed pretty good chunk of time nursing ankle or foot.
And he had a nice tournament run, remember that, late in the season last year?
Yeah, he just brings a physicality. He's a hard-nosed, tough football player. His dad, of course, Steve Young, the head football coach for the Rockets. And just brings a physical presence to that Neenah lineup. There's a triple for Luke Kreitzer, speaking of good football players, like you said, Ricardo. Did a fantastic job quarterbacking the Lightning this season.
Up top to Corso. Corso, one of my Fab Five, Brett.
Yeah, and what a season he's had. 1,000-point score now. Great career. Wunderlich from the corner. No good. And the Lightning now with a chance to tie or maybe even take the lead here in this FBA finale. Like now some of the Lightning starters getting ready to come back in, but instead Gilbolt is going to the line.
Yeah, nearly 5 minutes of play to start the game for the seniors for Appleton North and Gilbo.
Nice ovation, Ricardo, for the seniors coming out. They played well in those first 5 minutes.
Held the fort, right, if Gilbo's able to nail this free throw, Brett. And he
does. Neenah has a 9-game winning streak over Appleton North. I checked that out. Last time Lightning beat the Rockets, that was back on January 3rd, 2020. 2020, a 66-58 win right here at Appleton North. So it's been a while.
That was right before COVID.
Yeah, right before COVID hit. So it's been a while since the Lightning have knocked out the Rockets, and we're going to get a foul against Abilene North. Is that a shooting foul?
It's on number 5, Hardy.
So Cal Juckum, number 21, into the game for the Rockets, a 6'2 sophomore. Giving Lee Robus some good minutes for the Rockets. One of two for Juckum. Three players now have scored for Neenah. Rockets back on top, 6-5, as we look at our Cellcom ETS performance scoreboard. Good matchup between Nathan Ramos, number 4 for Appleton North, and Brady Corso, number 12. There it is right now. Nice move by Ramos. Oh, good catch by Will Sweeney.
It's almost like, whoa.
You got to him Will Sweeney. Yeah, Will Sweeney's in now. Right. Abraham Tomori, number 23. Grant Hardy, number 5. Kreitzer's still in for the Lightning as well. Is he? I'm trying to think. He might be a regular starter, though.
Kreitzer would be, yes.
Yeah, so regular starting 5 back in for the Lightning. Tomori with the ball, heck of a football player as well. If we're talking football, Ramos from deep. And good job walling out on that rebound. Rockets with it.
Six-five lead for Neenah. Near an 11:45 mark here in the first quarter. First half. Oh, Brett, I did it.
First quarter, yeah. Not quite.
Double team on Corso. That leaves Schultz open for the three. Not able to pull it down. I think that's Ramos with the rebound.
Kreitzer feeling it from the corner. Rims out. Rebound goes to Jansen. Three from the corner. Good. Boy, you leave him wide open. That's Juckum, Ricardo. He's got four.
Yeah.
Second triple of the game for the Rockets. Boy, you got to close out.
You do. Good matchup there.
I was talking about Appleton North. Well, let's see what Grant Hardy does. A little scoop shot. No. Loose ball. Who's going to come up with it? The Rockets do. That was Juckum out to number 13, Grant Dean. And it knocked away. But, you know, Appleton North, really cold shooting from three-point range has played a role in that current skid of four losses in its past five games. Lightning are 28 of 102 from distance in losses against Oconomowoc, twice to Appleton East and Kokona. That's just 27%.
Ah, good analysis there, BC.
Yeah.
That's why you're the best.
In its win, though, against Fond du Lac, the Lightning shot 13 of 26 from three-point range. Now, Appleton North enters tonight's action with the most three-point makes, 204, and attempts, 584 in the FVA. So, again, they're a team that can get sizzling hot from distance, but lately really struggling from the outside. If they can get that going, they're going to be a very, very dangerous team in the postseason. And they all can shoot it. Well, nice little bounce pass. Leung off the glass, too strong. Hardy with the rebound.
Inside to Tomori.
Offensive foul.
It's on Sweeney. 9-5 lead for Neenah, 9:48 left here in the first half. From Appleton North High School. Speaking of Appleton North, Brett, they have a trio of wrestlers down at the state individual wrestling tournament.
Yeah, you just did a nice story.
Yeah, I did. They have Brock Arndt. They have expected to compete at 285. And then they got Stoffel, the returning champ. As that three-pointer is good.
Juckum, he's red hot. Two triples for Juckum. He's got 7 points.
And then a little bit of a surprise making it down there, Blake Miller. If you can, read my story on the three seniors for Appleton North.
You'll be heading down to Madison tomorrow.
I will.
For the individual state wrestling tournament. There's Tomori with a big answer. That's the second triple now for the Lightning in a much-needed basket right there.
And I need to mention, Neenah has two wrestlers down there, Jacob Herm and Declan Cook. I see Declan Cook already qualified into the quarterfinals.
Okay.
For Neenah.
Congratulations to him. Juckum feeling it from the corner.
It looked good off the hand.
It did. Boy, you get him going. I think that opens some things up for Brady Corso. Corso, I don't believe, has even taken a shot yet for Neenah, their leading scorer. One of the FVA's leading scorers as well. Well, good luck down in Madison, Ricardo.
Thank you. Wrestling boy, as I like to call myself.
Be reading your coverage.
I got that and the team tournament next Friday and Saturday down there at the Cole Center, Kokona, Wauwega, Fremont.
Okay.
Are our two area schools. I might help out with Lux Casco and whoever else is down there for the Green Bay area as well.
Kokona going for the four-peat. Grant Dean. Gotta like Kokona's chances, don't you?
Oh, I do.
That's not really going out on a limb, I know.
No. We'll see. The Central Group has Wisconsin Rapids back at state.
Okay, so. Boy, you talk about a historic wrestling dynasty, right? A power, the Red Raiders. When we did that live stream, Neenah and Superior, there's a deep three by, that was the Rockets' Justin Jansen. We were there at Wisconsin Rapids High School when Neenah and Superior played in a sectional championship game, and you could see all those banners for wrestling across the way.
nearing the 7:40 mark here in the first half. 12-8 lead for Neenah.
Low scoring game. Oh, I thought Sweeney was going to let it fly.
To Ramos.
30-second timeout. Yeah, I don't think Chris Kellett liked quite what was going on there. Regroup, maybe come out with a set play to get a bucket or at least a good look. Of course, Chris Kellett, former Neenah standout, head coach at Appleton North. We've talked about him in previous streams, but his sixth season here as a head coach. Much needed stability, right, to this program has guided the Lightning to winning seasons. Well, I guess three of the past 4 years, sectional semifinal appearance last season, but as mentioned, I covered him when he was a Neenah standout. Then he went on to Ripon, where he was a two-sport standout in football and basketball. So doing some good things. Here is Chris Kellett, making me feel old. Talk about Lee Rubus and his success in a little while as well, but his record with the Rockets and what he's done with that program. I think Mark Miller, our friend at WithSports.net, kind of called him the current-day Ron Einerson. Number of state trip appearances already under Lee Rubus's watch, caretaker of a historic program. And how about Amari Toure going strong with the left hand? He's got 5 points back to a two-point game as we look at our CellCom and ETS performance scoreboard.
Yeah, he has North's last 5 points, to be more specific. 7 minutes now left here in the first half.
Wunderlich, they're kind of letting them through, but now who's going to come down with it? Loose ball, and boy, there's a battle between two football players, Tamari and Young, but the Lightning come up with it.
There's Ramos.
Ramos going to be off the glass, and we're tied up. Ramos' first points of the night.
7-0 run here by the Appleton North Lightning, Brett.
It's a good matchup, too, between Sweeney and Wunderlich. Corso, again, I don't think he's taken a shot yet. Oh, I thought maybe Juckum was thinking about it. Boy, Young inside and a strong finish by Wunderlich. Wunderlich's first bucket of the night. Good team basketball by the Rockets. Actually, both teams doing a really good job, Ricardo, moving and sharing the ball. Little hedge, and they're going to get Jansen on the foul. That's going to be his second.
6:11 left here in the first half, so Jansen with his second foul remains in the game. See Rubus.
Always very nicely dressed, isn't he?
Oh yeah, you gotta love the classic suit and tie. Not enough coaches do that, in my opinion.
After COVID, that a lot of coaches got away from that, at least at the college and pro level. Sometimes I watch Chris Kellett. He's got some pants where he'll like pull them up during a game. Is that going to be on Jansen again? Well, that's his third.
Oh, Brett, and I had said I thought that was odd that he was still in the game, but now he has that third foul with 6 minutes left.
Yeah, he'll be out the entire rest of this half with those three fouls.
Big old 6'11" senior center Ethan Hetzel.
Sweeney with a quick trigger off the inbounds, no good, and here comes Wunderlich and the Rockets. See number 34, Ethan Holzel, 6'11" senior. Now he's got it on the block. Still waiting for there. Oh, I thought maybe Corso was gonna.
He's being guarded by Tamari though. Brett.
Yeah, he's eyeing up that three, but he's affected the game in other ways. Some assists, I think a rebound or two already. Young, if he wants a nice little leaner, nice finish by Luke Young, and he's got four. Ricardo, that's an old school move right there.
It is.
Final tune-up for both of these squads as they get ready for postseason play. March 1st, next time these teams are in action. I think Young got his hand on it, forces the turnover. Here comes Corso. Corso, the lefty, being very patient right now. A nice little cut inside. Tough shot. That was Grant Dean trying to make something happen, but that was good defense by the Lightning. Really bottling him up. Yeah, you can't leave Sweeney wide open. Just a little off, but Ricardo, from our vantage point, that looked like it was going to go down.
Good hard rebound by Corso. Brett, I have both teams combined for one turnover.
Good clean game.
Yes.
Not a lot of fouls, knock on wood, either. Be sure to stay here at halftime. We'll get our thoughts maybe on the tournament pairings, right? And again, a little bit of a disrespect, I think, the HAL 9000 showed the Fox Valley Association. A bit underseeded, these teams. Of course, was kind of looking at Holzel. Now Holzel outside with it. Deep three by Corso, wow. And finally lets it fly. His first shot attempt of the night is a triple. And Corso showing that range and why he's a 1,000 point scorer. There's a turnover, a little miscommunication. Holzel got it, now gives it out to Corso. Corso, he can, that's not deep, right? He's gonna take it. A little short this time. Try to do a little Steph Curry action right there. Three, four, that's number two. Braden Heckel with the miss. Holzel with a rebound.
Brett, now you're seeing where those misses are really hurting Appleton North because a lot of them are one and done.
Right, three-point shots, right, long rebounds, of course, but Neenah corralling those. Don't have the three-point stats in front of us, but again, a little bit of a struggle from distance. Somehow Appleton North's got to shoot its way out of that. And again, I said, Holzel, the 6'11".
Not a bad shot.
Yeah, center's going to take it. Looked pretty good. Have a guy that can stretch the floor like that at that size. Ooh, I think the Rockets fans wanting a push off instead. It's going to go to Neenah. Be sure to check out postcrescent.com later tonight. I see our guy Dan Powers is over there, our photojournalist. He's shooting some photos. I think the rest of the USA Today Network Wisconsin photography staff is down in Madison for the state individual wrestling tournament.
Yeah, I know Torque is and Glashin for sure.
Yeah, and I think Gary Klein from Sheboygan, Manitowoc area is down there as well. Corso showing off his handle and a little short jumper. Ooh, looked pretty good for Nick Schultz.
Well, that'll stay with Appleton North. Not only that, our former photographer, Samantha Madar, is down there. Remember her?
There's Dan Powers checking out what he's got. Yeah, I do remember her.
She works for the State Journal now.
Definitely check out Dan Powers, all his great stuff later tonight. He's got a full day. He's been busy all day long. Just a little over 2 minutes to play.
Oh,
kind of a fast-moving first half, Ricardo.
Yeah, North folks wanted a turnover there.
Grant Hardy now working against Wunderlich. Good patience offensively, good defense by the Rockets. There's a three off target for Ben Zablowski. And the Rockets now with a minute and a half or so to go, up seven as we look at our Cellcom ETS performance scoreboard.
Boy, if that holds, that's 12 points. It's got to be a low for the season for a first half for Appleton North.
Remember again that first game, what was that, 57-37? Ooh, deep three again off target. Rockets winning that one, so defensively did a good job of holding Appleton North down, and I think, yeah, with Grant Hardy on that baseline, looks like that's the call. So a turnover here with a minute 16 to go. Brady Corso, Ricardo, a St. Leo commit.
Yeah,
St. Leo, Florida. Coached by Lance Randall. That Oshkosh West, remember back in the day, to back-to-back D1 state titles, 06 and 07. And also Brady Corso, he comes into tonight's game with 1,262 career points, just the fifth player in program history with 1,000-plus career points. That is still hard to believe. The great rich tradition of Neenah boys basketball.
They must have had a bunch of guys like right there, like maybe over 900.
I always wonder like what Wayne Kreklo, he was a 1975 grad, ended up playing for the Boston Celtics. I think he was on that 80-81 Celtics title team.
Kreklo, that sounds like What a great name. That just sounds like something out of Game of Thrones.
Big in the volleyball scene, I believe, Wayne Creclo as well.
House Creclo.
You know, a lot of those, all these players have scored their 1,000 points recently. Max Klesmet, Matt Height, or Helt, I should say, and Corso with the bucket. Speaking of Mr. 1,000, he'll go to the line for the three-point play. Ramos picks up the foul, his first. Yeah, but I got Max Klesmet, Matt Helt, Chevalier, Emery Jr., and Carter Thomas, all recent graduates, right? Klesmet, of course, currently a starter for the Badgers men's basketball team. He has the program record with 1,636 points. Corso now with 6 points for his night, so that gives him 1,268.
10-0 run by the Rockets, Brett. That came off a 7-0 run from Appleton North.
Klesmet with the Badgers. Carter Thomas with Oshkosh. A little two-man game there, and instead Wunderlich's going to the line.
Right, Appleton North, I want to say of their last six possessions, four have come with turnovers.
Matt Helt, of course, played at Marquette. Chevalier Emery Jr., he's at the JUCO level right now.
He's going to transfer.
Yeah, well, he started at Merrimack and transferred, went to JUCO. Yeah, he'll. I think I just looked it up. I forget where he's at, but he's averaging like 17-plus a game. Boy, what a player he was. Remember that great three-point buzzer beater against Kimberly in a sectional semifinal a couple years back? That was the year that the Rockets won the state championship two seasons ago. Levinol run, Ricardo, for the Rockets.
That's what I have.
Last 15 seconds here of this opening half. Again, stick with us at halftime. We'll give our thoughts on the seedings, the Division I tournament pairings, and again, FBA a little bit undersold, we think. Let's see what Appleton North wants to do. Sweeney, what's the call here? A travel with 1.4 seconds to go.
Yeah, this flurry of turnovers by Appleton North has really made it disjointed for them offensively.
Of course, they're going to play quarterback here. Whoa, deep throw. Juckum just throws it up.
He was able to get it off. Was amazing. 23-12 is your halftime score, Brett.
Yep, yeah. As we look at our Cellcom ETS performance scoreboard, yep, Rockets on top, 23-12 over the Lightning in this FBA regular season finale. We'll talk about tonight's game and, again, the brackets in the postseason, what's to come for these two teams and the FBA in general after we return from this short break.
Every day is a new chance to do the right thing. At Cellcom, doing the right thing means keeping you at the center of all that we do. It's technology with a heartbeat.
Promote your business, unite your team, or just get your name out there with help from the professionals at Cooney's Embroidery and Sportswear. Family owned and operated for over 20 years, we have the skills and experience to customize your apparel and spread the word about your business or organization. We can put your logo, name, or anything else you want on any article of clothing. From embroidery and screen printing to graphic design and heat press services, we've got you covered. Call today.
We'll be right back.
top of the 222 building on College Avenue in downtown Appleton. It's Varsity Roundtable. Ladies and gentlemen, Ricardo Arguello.
Welcome back to Appleton North High School. Again, it's halftime here. We look at our Cellcom ETS performance scoreboard. Rockets on top of Appleton North, 23-12. Fox Valley Association regular season finale. I'm Brett Christopherson with USA Today Network Wisconsin, hanging out as always with Ricardo Arguello, Jim Rosandick. And Ricardo, briefly maybe some first half thoughts, I guess, from Appleton North standpoint. Cold three-point shooting, but a flurry of turnovers down the stretch here in the first half.
And I think that has been key. I think six of the nine final possessions ended in, or five of the final nine possessions ended in a turnover, Brett. And when you're struggling, each one of those possessions becomes so important on offense. And 12 points, that's got to be the low point for a first half for them throughout the year. I can't imagine them scoring less than that throughout the season.
Especially with guys that have the firepower that we've seen out of Appleton North, right?
But give credit to Neenah. Neenah, 11-0 run. At one point it was 12-12. Appleton North had actually gone on a 7-0 run to crawl back in the game. I think Tamari had five of those 7 points. And then Neenah responds, right? A Neenah team that's really been playing well. Eight of their last nine wins out of the past nine games. And I think Brady Corso really showed you the completeness of him as a player.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe he didn't score a whole bunch of points, Brett, but he got it done in a number of different ways. Rebounds, defense, passing the ball. There's a reason why he's on my Fab Five, and that's a big reason why, is his versatility as an overall player.
Well, we'll see how the second half plays out here. We got 5 minutes to go here at halftime. Gives us enough time to talk. Now, listen, let's talk WIA brackets, okay, right? Fox Valley Association, Ricardo, the highest seed for the FVA was a number three for conference champion Oshkosh North.
Okay, now, first off, before you go on, I think that was given the sectional.
Yeah, it's a tough sectional.
It's a tough sectional, and you could make a case for that.
I thought maybe
But then
two.
What you're going to say next with the next seed's ridiculous.
Well, right. That's sectional two. I was just saying that's the top seed for Oshkosh North. That's the same side as DePere, I believe.
Yeah.
Obviously the overall number one. That's sectional two. But on the other side of the bracket, Kaukauna came out with the FVA's best seed at number five.
Right.
Neenah is next at number six. Appleton North, number eight. Kimberly, number nine.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, Marshfield, they're the top seed. Spash number two, then Superior at number three, and Eau Claire Memorial at number four. Now, come on. You're going to tell me you're going to put Superior in Eau Claire Memorial ahead of any team in the FVA? I mean, come on. If you look at sports, Mark Miller even said, is this going to be kind of that motivation for maybe the teams in perhaps the state's best overall conference? He said, I'm not going to bet against any of these teams to maybe kind of blow up that bracket and what the computer seeding came out with.
Well, not just that. And then I thought there was way too much love given to the Central, of the Valley. Why am I blanking here? You know what I'm talking
about. Wisconsin Valley Conference.
Wisconsin Valley Conference. I mean, come on, man. They haven't been relevant since the Hauser years.
Although I thought Spash did pretty well against the FVA this season.
Yeah,
right?
I know that, but still, overall, the strength of the FVA much, much stronger than the Wisconsin Valley. But I guess, what can you say, Brett? The games will kind of show us if we're right or if we're wrong. Maybe we're dead wrong. Maybe the Wisconsin Valley is the league this year, right?
Well, I tell you what. I mean, the second round matchup, assuming Neenah wins, and Superior is hosting Hortonville. Would not surprise me to see Hortonville go up to Superior as a 14 seed and beat the Spartans.
Oh, I think Appleton East could give, is it Eau Claire Memorial?
Yes, because Eau Claire Memorial is out with, Jesperson is out. Is it Cooper Jesperson, their standout?
Yes, so they have a shot. Even with Cooper Jesperson, I think they have a shot, because I think Appleton East is a team that's a little bit hot and cold. If you get them on a hot night, if the young La Chapelle kid is shooting the rock, Brett, we've seen him go off for nearly 40 points. He can lift the team. Sometimes it's how hot you are in a certain game to pull off the upset. I wouldn't put it past him to beat Eau Claire
Memorial. So that would be a 13 taking down a 4. So the Patriots playing pretty good basketball. Of course, Kimberly and Appleton North play each other next Friday night, so they're going to negate each other. That's an 8-9. That's a good matchup in a regional semifinal right here at Appleton North. But you're looking at Spash. They potentially could meet up. It would not surprise me, Ricardo, Neenah being a 6 seed. I think they take down Eau Claire North. And then I think they can take down a Superior team if they have to go to Superior. Next thing you know, they're taking on Spash in the sectional semifinal on Thursday night, March 7th at Appleton East High School.
How about Freedom getting our only number one seed?
Yes.
And look, Xavier's in the same division with, or same sectional with Keele, right? They got a two seed. Brilliant got the three. I understand that, but it definitely was an odd seeding scenario this season. And, you know, I know I was looking at some of the Twitter comments. Some of the coaches are upset with how it's going. But, hey, they wanted this, Brett. Well, let's get back down. We had Steph Hauser on the 920 Sports podcast, and she said, all the hollering and stuff, you wanted this. You wanted the computer seating.
This isn't us doing at the meeting of the WIAA.
You got what you wanted. Yeah. And this just leads into the overall mentality, Brett, that no matter what you do, someone's going to be mad.
Yeah, but this computer seating, and we've seen it in football too, it's just they got to tweak it a little bit, right, to make it a little bit more realistic. Of course, from our standpoint, from a football standpoint, we saw Appleton North and Kimberly in week 9 right here on a rainy night. All of a sudden, week 1, they're playing each other in a football playoff. I mean, that seemed to be a little bit odd,
too. Was it a 14-7 game? Or I can't remember what. It was very close.
Yeah.
So I could have easily seen Appleton North making it to the semifinals, which Kimberly did, unfortunately falling to Milwaukee Marquette. Brett, again, I mentioned that only because I love that stadium.
Sun
Prairie Stadium.
Bank of Sun Prairie Stadium Ashley Field, Bank of Sun Prairie Stadium. But they there needs to be some tweaking, some fixing to how this computer seating is all going down. But you're right. If the FEA feels like it's underseeded like we do, then you go out and prove it, right? And we'll see how it all plays out. Hey, first half scoring for the Rockets. Jansen with 3, Young with 4, Corso with 6 late points. Juckum leads the Rockets with 7, Wunderlich with 3. For the Lightning, Ramos with 2, Kreitzer with 3, Gilboat with 2, and Tomori with 5. About ready to get the second half. The final 18 minutes of the regular season, then it is postseason play for the boys as well. Our next Varsity Game of the Week basketball live stream is to be determined. Not sure what we're going to be doing. We'll be streaming boys and girls postseason basketball. I'll announce our next matchup on my Twitter account, so give me a follow, at PCBrettC. Could be a girls sectional semifinal. Maybe we'll do the double dip. Talking to Rosie on that following Saturday. Maybe we could do a boys regional followed by a girls sectional championship followed by a boys regional final. But anyway, you can access our previous Game of the Week live streams on our USA Today Network Wisconsin websites. Just go to the sports section and scroll down until you see the Watch Our Varsity Game of the Week Prep Live Streams link. Neenah with the ball to open the second half. Ball was tipped, so Rockets maintain possession. What are they in here, Ricardo? Is this a... It almost looks like... Is this a box and one? I can't tell, but... Oh, there's a steal! And Ricardo, you got, I think, some more seniors starting this game here in the second half for the Lightning, not the regular starting five. So kind of in a funky defense, it looked like, to start out. Looked like they were shadowing Corso, but then maybe playing a zone with the other four guys. Bounce pass. Nice feed. And how about that? That's number 32, Nathan Stanislawski.
Brett, by the way, that was Nina's first turnover of the game.
Is that right? So they clean first half. Wunderlich from the corner. Ooh, off the side of the backboard, but Luke Young picks it up, kicks out. Remember, Jansen now, number 3 for the Rockets. He has those 3 fouls. And we're going to get a blocking call against Stanislawski.
It's always rough when you get the blocking foul, Brett, and then you end up on your tush.
Yeah, you're waiting for the official to kind of put his hand on the back of his head and point the other way for offensive foul charge, but nope, they said a blocking. How about that? Is inbound. Leung can't finish it. And the Lightning trying to chip away at this second half deficit. Nice little bounce pass. Nice cut, and look at that finish. There's Heckel. Seniors giving the Lightning a little juice here to start not only the game, but here the second half. almost like a matchup zone with one player always on Brady Corso. Three, no good, and the rebound to the Lightning. Schultz called for the foul, first one of the half for the Rockets. Again, red hot Rockets, 12 of 13, winners of since the 2018-19 season. We're going to talk about the Rockets' success. Three ball,
ooh,
and Young with the rebound. They're not. Corso looks a little. It's like, come on. That's Will Gilboat following a Corso around everywhere.
Yeah. Gilboat does a lot of the dirty stuff. He's a good defender. Obviously, you get that assignment as that. It's up and good.
Floater by Wunderlich now with five.
Good ball movement for North.
Larson Hager with it. The three-point attempt now with the basketball. Again, offensive rebound for the Lightning from the top. That was Braden Heckel with the miss. Corso looking for an opening. And Corso going to take it. Defense didn't know where he was. They were a little bit of a mix-up there, and offensive rebound, Stanislavski diving for it, but it's going to go with the Rockets.
Yeah.
Good hustle by Stanislavski. Since the 2018 season, 18-19 season, Neenah, 128-32 overall, an even 800 winning percentage. 85-22 in the FBA. It's a 794 winning percentage. Of course, it's a pair of FBA titles, a D1 state title, three state tournament appearances. Remember, they won it at 29-1 two seasons ago. First class or first state title for the Rockets since that Class A state championship back in 1978 under the legendary Ron Einerson. Wunderlich with a bucket there, 27-16, back to an 11-point lead, and that's definitely an off-target wayward pass, so turnover Appleton North. And now some of the regular starters back in for the Lightning. Pretty good basketball for the Rockets, I'd say, in recent seasons. Of course, Lee Rubbis now in his ninth season, 168-64 with Neenah, 271-120 overall in his career. Three by Jansen, no good. Hardy with the rebound. Final tune-up, as I said, in the first half. Both these two teams will get ready for postseason play on March 1st. Appleton North home against Kimberly. The Rockets.
Get Hardy. Right hand.
Home against Eau Claire North. Is that Grant Hardy with the bucket? His first points of the night. Low scoring game here. Three from the top. Nothing but net. And Schultz, his first bucket of the game is a three-pointer. I believe this is the largest lead of the night for the Rockets at 12.
Foul on the floor. 12:34 left in the second half, 30-18 lead for Neenah as Tomori now checks in for Larson Hager.
Grant Hardy, of course, a D2 offer from Northern Michigan. Already.
Possession stays with Appleton North.
30-18, Rockets with the lead as we look at our Cellcom ETS performance scoreboard. Tamori trying to do a little work, a little hook shot, nice move. That's pretty much all but done when Tamori gets the ball that deep in the paint.
Yeah, he was able to really elevate Brett and put in that little baby hook.
Schultz, I thought maybe he was going to let it go. Oh, he is. Nobody's on him. And Tamori with it. Yeah, it's going to be on Schultz again. That's his third. Three quick fouls now on Schultz. Been a pretty good run for Northeast Wisconsin. You think, what, 29-1 two seasons ago for the Rockets boys? Last year, 30-0 for the DePere boys. Wasn't all that long ago. Spash was dominating. Oshkosh North winning a state title. As Ramis from the top, ooh, buries it. Ramis, his first triple, 5 points now. And now the Lightning kind of creeping back into this one, down seven. DePere, of course, the prohibitive favorite to win again. And I included those Spash teams. I guess I'm thinking more Gannett, you know, USA Today Network, Wisconsin teams winning state titles at the D1 level. But definitely Fox Valley and Northeast Wisconsin really having a nice run. Yeah, see, Ricardo, it's not just Madison and Milwaukee.
Oh, absolutely. Every year I have to battle with the other reporters on that, Brett. Look at Tamori skying for that rebound. And, you know, DePere, Brett, friends of the varsity roundtable.
Yeah, I'm not sure who's going to take them down. I guess anything can happen. They're in a tough sectional. Sweeney short on that one. Potential, DePere Arrowhead or DePere Oshkosh North sectional championship game that will be held at Oshkosh North tentatively. I think if the Spartans are in that, they'd have to move that game, obviously. But
move it to the Colf.
Yeah, those days are done.
Unfortunately.
Oh, remember those great games at the Brown County, the old Brown County Arena? That was good, like a mini state tournament. Nice cut and find Luke Young with the basket. Now a timeout for
Brett,
the Rockets.
That old Brown, it was a little bit of a dump.
It was, but it was fun. That was, boy, there was some big-time atmospheres. I covered some of those games.
I saw a few concerts there, Rosie.
Those are some intense battles. Remember those great Seymour teams? It was always like the Seymour sectional, but there was D1 would play there. Remember seeing Appleton North and Appleton West going at it. Yeah, Colf, I covered some games there where Colf was jam-packed. Still get some great atmospheres, but those were the days, huh? Kind of miss those. I'm trying to think, did Quant Fieldhouse and Stevens Point ever have sectional games? I don't think so. Maybe. That would have been a good venue as well. Still good atmosphere, though, Ricardo, when these gyms get packed. Look, a little water on the floor. Look at Chris Kellett doing some work. He's not only a coach, but he's a cleaner-upper.
That's right.
There he is. Let's see if the Lightning can make this a ball game here in these final 10 minutes.
Sweeney against Grant Dean.
I tell you, they get hot in that three-point shooting. They're right back in it. Grant Hardy going to work hard. Tough shot off the glass through contact. And now Hardy with 4 points all this half.
7-point lead seems to be a little bit of a bugaloo for Appleton North.
Trailed by as many as 12, though, 30-18.
Haven't been able to get closer.
Oh, nice.
Ramis.
Yeah, what are we going to get? Get a fall on Corso, but nice job, Ramis, coming in with help. Getting those fast hands, knocking it away from Corso. Now Corso picks up the foul.
Brett, we only had, in this half, we only have 3 turnovers. And then in the first half, we had 5 turnovers all by Appleton North. So, like you said, a pretty clean game.
Clean game and not a ton of fouls either. Just letting these kids play. close out on that was Grant Dean closing out on Will Sweeney. Looked like Sweeney maybe thought he had an opening for a three, but Dean there quickly. Of course, Dean with the basketball. How about the year he had on the gridiron as well? Your Post Crescent Football Player of the Year with the basketball right now. Some good all-around multi-sport athletes both sides. Of course, that leads me into what we're planning right now with tough turnaround by Corso. Rims out. Look at Tamari, speaking of a good football player. Planning is underway for our Northeast Wisconsin High School Sports Awards show June 13th at the Lambeau Field Atrium in Green Bay. Fall nominees are out. You can find them on postcrescent.com, greenbaypressgazette.com. Go to sports. You'll see the Northeast Wisconsin High School Sports Award show link. Pretty soon we'll start getting the winter nominees released as well, but looking forward to getting back to a live and in-person format, Ricardo. You and I will be the MCs. Rosie will be there making sure the live stream looks good. Of course, Mike Sherry, our colleague, a huge, huge helper in getting that show off and running as well. We've been told it's one of the best in the company. Ooh, tough finish by Jansen now with 5 points. And a 9-point lead. You know, these two coaches, Ricardo, I was looking this up as well. As now we get some full court press and Dean with the foul. Both these coaches, Lee Rubbis for Neenah, Chris Kellett for Appleton North, collegiate experience as well when it comes to coaching.
Pretty thorough resume for both. As we have a timeout by Appleton North with 8:09 left in the second half. Your score, 34-25 for Appleton North. Again, on your CellCom ETS scoreboard.
Yeah, Kellett was an assistant at Lawrence University two times, two stints, one of which included a short stint as the Vikings' interim head coach.
Whoa.
That was during the 2017-18 season. Rubbis, meanwhile, he led, remember this, UW-Fox Valley to
yes.
a 136-23 record over a six-season span, dominant. Junior college team. His previous coaching gig was at UW-Fox Valley before taking over the Neenah program. But Rubbis was also an assistant at Lawrence from 04 and through 09 under the great John Tharp. Vikings, some great teams back in the day. Back then, Chris Breyer, remember him? And at one point, Lawrence ranked number one in the nation. Almost got to the Final Four, but the Vikings won four Midwest Conference championships over that stretch. Kellett first joined Lawrence, the staff, in 2010, so his time with the Vikings didn't overlap Rubbis, at least that's to my understanding. But not bad when you got some collegiate experience on the sidelines as well. Some good basketball minds when it comes to Chris Kellett and Lee Rubbis.
See if we can get you updated on who has made the semifinals. And of the Appleton North or Neenah kids.
Talk about state wrestling.
State wrestling, yes, sorry. Declan Cook, we said at 138, is in. Jacob Herm, also in to the semifinals tomorrow, Brett.
There you go. Congrats.
Check the Appleton North kids.
Ramos coming off the screen, but can't get that one to fall. Good look.
Jake Stoffel of Appleton North at 175. He's into the semis. As is Brock Arndt at 285, heavyweight break.
Good steal by Ramos there, trying to get the entry pass into Luke Young, but again, those quick hands by Ramos.
Nearing the 7 minute mark left here in the second half.
Just not a lot of shots there right now, Ricardo.
No.
Neenah really playing tight defensively. A little turnaround by Kreitzer though in that short corner area. Nice job by Kreitzer now, who has 5. 7 point game.
Thank you.
Rockets. Ricardo in no hurry to shoot.
No. I was going to say, they're really looking for a great shot, taking their time.
Good defense, though, of course, by Appleton North as well. Not a lot there so far, but a good patience. When you're up seven, no need to rush. Wunderlich. That's a good shot right there by Wunderlich, and a timeout coming for the Rockets.
See if I can read off some more of our kids making it to the state semifinals. Andy DePiazza of Kokon at 106. Brett, we're going to have a bunch here.
You're going to be busy.
Cash Botting of Hortonville at 126 into the semifinals. Lucas Peters of Hortonville at 132 in Division I into the semifinals, as well as Hortonville's Nolan Skeba. We mentioned a Clan Cook, Jacob Herm. Henry Neibauer of Hortonville at 150 into the semifinals. This is all D1, by the way. I am going to be busy, Brett. Liam Crook of Kokona, 165 into the semifinals. We talked about Stoffel at 175. And then, of course, Brock Arndt at 285. That's all in Division I. Brett, that's help me. I'm gonna need more help. I'm going to check Division II here shortly.
Mike Sherry's going to go down there, right, our colleague?
He's going to have to.
Boy, wrestling's always been good around here, but, boy, it seems like lately, in the last handful of years, it's really taken off. Don't forget, you've got girls wrestling, too. I know we're going to have a number of state champs, I believe, in our USA Today Network Wisconsin schools as well on the girls' side. Wrestling and girls volleyball really have just skyrocketed around here. Loose ball, and the Rockets with it. Grant Dean came down with it. Now Jansen over, whoop, knocked away by Ramos.
It's going to stay with Neenah, though.
Hey, if you don't have anything going on tomorrow night and you're not going to state wrestling, you might want to go to Neenah High School, Ricardo.
Why is that?
Neenah girls basketball standout Allie Zabel will be presented with a commemorative McDonald's All-American basketball jersey prior to the Rockets' D1 regional semifinal against Wisconsin Rapids. That's tomorrow. The game's scheduled to tip off at 7 p.m. at Neenah High School. That's in Fox Crossing, by the way, but the ceremony is scheduled to begin at 6:35 p.m. Of course, Zabel, a UConn commit, only the seventh Wisconsin girls basketball player, the first in the Fox Valley to be named to the prestigious McDonald's All-American team. And that game will be played April 2nd at the Toyota Center in Houston at 5:30 p.m. It's going to be on ESPN2, so we can watch. But Zabel enters postseason action. 2,625 career points. That is fourth in state girls basketball history.
The basketball game is going to be on ESPN2?
McDonald's All-American game.
Oh, McDonald's. Sorry. I thought you meant the Neenah Rapids.
No. We're talking the McDonald's All-American
Sorry
game
about that,
on
Ty.
April 2nd. But, yeah, go check it out. That's pretty cool to see that. She getting her McDonald's All-American commemorative jersey. Grant Hardy rims out. Loose ball. And somehow Appleton North was able to come up with it. But congratulations to Allie Zabel. What an honor. And not only the first Valley girl to be named to that McDonald's All-American team, we believe the first overall since Brian Butch, right? In 03 for Appleton West. I believe
That's
he was
true.
The last one, maybe the only two, right, in the Valley. And also want to say, this doesn't pertain to either of the two teams on the floor, but congratulations to Hortonville standout Rainey Wilson. I see she announced her college choice. She's going to be in the Big Ten, but it's going to be in Maryland. She's going to be a Terrapin.
That's right.
Carter,
talked to her dad yesterday, and she had her choice of three schools, Utah, obviously Maryland, and Iowa.
Iowa, home of Caitlin Clark.
She had 20 offers, according to her dad. Uh-huh.
I believe it.
Those three were the top ones.
I'd love to see the full list. They really, oh, a nice steal. Ramos, boy, how many steals does he have tonight? Schultz picks up his fourth. That's the seventh team foul now for the Rockets, so 1-1. Coming up now for Appleton North, Ramos chance to cut this down to six. But really, the Rainey and their family, in a day when everything is available information-wise, really kept that close to the vest. Had no idea any of the schools. We tried to break some news when they were on the Varsity Roundtable show a few weeks back. Hey, let us know. But no, she was tight-lipped about it. Even her teammates.
Real hush-hush.
Yeah, so good job by the Wilson family on keeping things quiet. But congratulations. Unfortunately, another good one leaving the state, though, Ricardo.
Yeah, we talked about that at length, about the unfortunate, well, Greasy Gresh is going to Wisconsin.
She's going to Wisconsin, yep.
Can you imagine if they would have kept Zabel there? The other one.
K.K. Arnold.
K.K. Arnold.
She's at UConn.
Tegan Malegny from McFarland.
Wait, where's she going? She in Iowa?
Yeah, Iowa. Going to Iowa. No. It's unfortunate.
Of course, Rainey, we think very highly of her game. We think she's clearly one of the best players in the state of Wisconsin. She's coming back for a senior year. So, but the Terps are getting a good one, and Schultz will be going to the line, shooting a pair for the Rockets. So I think, Ricardo, this game's got a little tight.
3:35 left here in the second half. 36-29 is your score with Neenah, 7-point lead, but
Schultz with
sophomore, 5'11" sophomore Nick Schultz trying to give them a 8-point lead if he can convert his second of his free throws.
3 points on the night to make it four now. He has a triple earlier this half. I was looking at the girls. I don't think Zabel, I think getting to third all time might be a chore. I think she might be a couple hundred points away, or maybe upper 100s away yet. I'd have to double check on that. But fourth ain't too bad all time, huh?
Well, it depends if she can make it to the state tournament.
Yeah, you figure what, four? That's
four games right there.
Plus maybe
sure.
Potentially two more at state. Yeah, you never know. Hardy, good defense by Wunderlich, and knocked away, and the Rockets have it. Young was out leading the break. Instead, to pass to Corso with the left hand. And Corso now with 8 points. Back up to a 10-point lead under 3 minutes to play. I know, Ricardo, you're going to be busy with state wrestling as Sweeney with Ricardo. That's Sweeney's first basket of the night.
Shocking.
And timeout.
Right, so.
But I was wondering what your game plan is for this game.
Well, I think I'm just going to get the box score and head out. I got to conserve, Brett. I'm in what they call the overtime aspect.
Got to be careful with that.
Limit that as much as possible. It's still going to be a fair amount of hours just because of the length of the wrestling tournament and the sheer number of guys we have.
Yeah.
But, yeah. But I'll catch back up. You know, I am doing a division-by-division preview on the tournament, Brett, that I hope to have out on Monday or Tuesday. We hope to also have an accompanying 9-2-0 Sports podcast kind of looking at the teams as well.
When are we going to plan on that?
Well, I was hoping Monday.
Monday? With Tyrese Halliburton?
Maybe. If you can get him to respond to me. But if not, I'm going to ask Mark Miller.
Yeah. Well, I can ask him, too, if you want me to.
Well, we might have it that, but I think there's a better chance of that happening.
Come on. Tyrese is a friend.
He is a friend, but the guy's just a busy guy. You know, I don't know if you know this, but he's an all-star.
He's one of the best players in the NBA is what he is right now. Whoa, what are we going to call there? An offensive foul on Wunderlich.
Yeah, it's funny. This is a few years ago. This is before when he was playing at Iowa State. I remember I was at Perkins with a female friend.
Yes, and I remember this.
This was at night, and he came in, and we were just kidding around. He saw me right away. We were kidding around a little bit, and I told my girlfriend, I'm like, remember this kid's name, just Tyrese Halliburton. He's going to be in the NBA.
Mm-hmm. Gilbolt from, was that Ramos with the dish?
It was.
Not only is Tyrese in the NBA, but geez.
Right, he's a cornerstone.
Oh,
he's a
man.
Franchise player.
He's a superstar.
Yeah. Making $50 million a year.
Bona fide superstar.
Uh-oh. This
Corso, all right.
You always got to be a little.
Mm-hmm.
Only 2:06 left here in the second half, Brett. Last thing you want to see is someone get hurt right before the tournament.
Tyrese, you're right. He's a cornerstone. He's a guy you can build a championship team around. And he's got a funky shot, but, man, they always drop. Some people thought he should have maybe won All-Star MVP, but I think Dame Lillard, he was lighting it up too.
Let me tell you something. I wonder in 10 or 15 years, and around the Indianapolis era, are we going to see a lot of kids shooting like Halliburton coming out of high school?
I still wonder if Sacramento regrets that decision, although Sabonis has really done well for the Kings as well. So it's kind of a win-win, I guess, for both teams.
Yeah, but it's hard to argue with Halliburton, though, Brett.
It
but
is.
For him, it's better from a personal standpoint. He's got over to Indianapolis, Brett. He's a franchise cornerstone guy. He's a guy that the community loves, and also, Brett, closer to Wisconsin.
Closer to home and,
and a little budding rivalry with the Bucks.
Well, he plays the Bucks a number of times. So, yeah, better than being out on the West Coast. Watch out! And the Lightning have it. And, whoa, are we going to get a foul? We're going to get a foul. Nope. Just out of bounds, okay.
Appleton North making it close here, Brad.
Yeah, it's not over yet. Just a two-possession game with a minute 34 to play as we look at our Cellcom ETS performance scoreboard. Regular season finale for these teams, boys across the state, right? And then it's on to postseason play. Grant Hardy now. He's going to try to work his way in. Oh, and they're going to get Jansen.
I know, Brett, in mid-December, we're thinking, man, this season's going to take forever. Mm-hmm. But it did actually go pretty quick.
Well, it helps when you have incredibly good weather.
That is true.
That was actually,
don't jinx it.
I was out on the bike today.
Put
in almost 15 miles on the bike.
I heard the rat, though, didn't see a shadow. So
isn't that a good thing?
Yeah, right? That's where I'm at.
Yeah. Oh, what are we going? Wow.
Brett, I thought you were going to give me a little grief because I called the gopher the rat or whatever it is, the woodchuck.
The
what is it,
groundhog.
Rosie? Groundhog, whatever. They're rodents.
Well, there's one in Sun Prairie, right, and one in, Pennsylvania somewhere.
Puxatani fell.
Ramos, a chance to get the Lightning even closer here. Ramos, the lefty, good on both. Look at this, Ricardo. We got a four-point game. Ramos with 9 points, seven this half.
Corso's going to get some attention here.
Also, 10-team fouls against the Rockets, so a double bonus the rest of the way.
And Appleton North has a few to give here.
Yep. Only the fifth. Double teamed. Whoa, Ramos thought he had maybe a steal there. That's going to be his third. There's the sixth team foul. So a minute seven to play. We're going to see the free throw game here in the last minute plus. Corso, that's the ball you want. He's a 90% plus free throw shooter. He's just going to hold on to it. You know the Lightning want to get it out of his hands. Instead, oh, look at this shot. Wow, what a finish by Corso. I think you have a name for that type of shot, Ricardo.
The scoop-de-loop.
And a full timeout for Neenah. Corso's like, I'm either going to shoot free throws at a 91% clip or I'm just going to take it in and do the scoop-de-loop, and he does. 41-35 lead for the Rockets as we look at our Cellcom ETS performance scoreboard.
Brett, it's the scoop-de-loo.
Scoop-de-loo.
Yes.
Not scoop-de-loop.
No.
Okay. Don't forget about that digital subscription right now. 6 months for just $1. You get complete digital access on any of our USA Today Network Wisconsin sites. That includes the Post Crescent, the Green Bay Press Gazette. The e-edition is part of that. Full access on your desktop, tablet, mobile devices every day. Exclusive subscriber newsletters. Full access to national reporting with the USA Today Sports Plus app. Just go to any of our websites. You should see a subscribe link at the top of the site. 6 months for $1. Can't go wrong with that deal. And again, give me a follow on Twitter, at PC Bretzi. I'll announce which postseason games we'll be doing. To be determined right now. Not sure if, I think with the girls' side, we're going to wait for the sectional.
Yeah.
Round, and then again, we might double up. We might do a double header if we do a sectional championship on the girls' side, maybe a boys' regional final, depending on the matchups as well. But I'll announce all of our Game of the Week matchups on my Twitter account, at PCBrettC, so give me a follow. North's got to do something here, Ricardo.
Yeah, they do. This 1-3-1 zone.
Yep. Ramos going to let it fly. Hits it. And a timeout coming. How about that against the zone? Second triple. And is this a full timeout? I believe it is. Yeah, but it's that's all North has left. So one timeout remaining. That was a good little wrinkle that I thought the Rockets coming out in that zone, but that was a deep three by Ramos, and now we have a three-point game. This is a 12-point lead, I think, the Rockets, so that was the largest here in the second half.
I think it was a 10-point lead?
I thought they were up 30 to 18 at one time.
Oh, let's look. Oh, yeah, you're right, Brett. I wasn't looking back far enough.
Neenah home against Eau Claire North on March 1st, Division I regional semifinal. Appleton North right here against Kimberly. That should be a great game in a regional semifinal as well. Both games March 1st and tip times 7 p.m. What do you like better? If you're the Rockets and taking on Eau Claire North, an uncommon opponent, or do you like the Appleton North way, knowing what you have to start the playoff run?
Great question. I think Eau Claire Memorial because
North, Eau Claire North.
Yeah, Eau Claire North because of the FEA is such a strong league.
Yep. No disrespect to the Big Rivers, but it is not the FEA, no doubt about it.
Yeah, a little disrespect.
Oh, good job getting it in. Now Corso trying to work his way, and he does. He's going to take, whoa, what do we have? Offensive foul on Corso.
Wow, and they were close to getting a foul there called on Kreitzer, Brett.
I thought against the sideline, maybe Corso was bumped before he got over the timeline. Rockets fans don't like it. But now with 26.1 seconds to play, a chance for the Lightning to tie this thing up. So they kind of let the bump, maybe a slight bump along that sideline go, but offensive foul against Corso. Now Ramos, who's been hot here this second half, he's got the ball.
Well, they got out of that zone defense now, Brett. Now it's a matter of finding a good shot if you're Appleton North with Sweeney.
Whoa, what do we have here? He stepped on the sideline.
Oh. Mm. Fifth turnover for North this half. 15.8 seconds left. Well, if you're Appleton North, you still got a shot here. Just got a foul right away, Brett.
Good job by the officiating crew, Ricardo. They were right on it. The official was right there to see that Sweeney stepped on the sideline. Now Corso is just going to dribble it. He's going to say, come follow me. He's double-teamed. And we have a timeout for the Rockets.
Not a little intense last few minutes.
Who says these games don't matter, right? Yeah. You got a Neenah team that's won 12 of 13. Definitely Rockets want to go into postseason play on a good note. Lightning with three straight losses, four losses in their last five games. They want to kind of reverse that trend and pick up a win before they get ready for the papermakers in postseason play. So we'll see with how much time is left. I forget what's left on the clock. They put the how much time is left in the timeouts here in the scoreboards. But we'll see what the Rockets are going to come out with here. Try to hold on to that basketball. Of course, the Lightning are going to try to force a steal here and maybe tie this thing up. Eight point five seconds to go as we look at our Cellcom ETS performance scoreboard. So you know the Rockets, Ricardo, definitely want to get it in the hands of number 12, Brady Corso.
He's being guarded by Ramos, and Sweeney looks like he's also keeping an eye on Corso.
Yep. Whoa, where's the foul? I think Holzel is going to go to the line. So Gilbo with the foul.
So 7th this will be a one-on-one?
Foul, yep. So Ethan Holzel looking for his first points of the night, and one-on-one, this front end, a big one for the Rockets. And the Neenah senior. Nothing but net. How about that? You knew he was in for a reason, Ricardo, not just his height, but you knew that Lee Rubbus felt pretty comfortable with his big senior at the free throw line, able to knock down some free throws, and that's what Ethan did right there. So a two-possession game with that big free throw, and look at that, nothing but net, piece of cake for the 6'11",
hey,
Ethan Hosel.
Good, nice, good form, good stroke.
Yeah,
for
looks
the senior.
Very good, and he gets a well-deserved bunch of high fives from his teammates, and a steal there too. Also a standing O from the Rockets fans. And one more foul. Looks like Nina's going to salt this one away.
Six turnovers for Appleton North in this half.
Jansen with 5 points. Still 1-1 with 2.1 seconds to go. Short on that. And that is how this game comes to a close. There's the buzzer. All zeros on the scoreboard, and that means Neenah with a 43-38 victory over Appleton North as we look at our CELCOM and ETS performance scoreboard. Don't forget to follow Ricardo. He's updating his Twitter account, Ricardo De Leon. I'm also at PC Bretzi. Again, I'll let everybody know who our next Varsity Game of the Week live stream will be. But it will be postseason playback. Go ahead, Ricardo.
I'm sorry. Real quick for both teams. First off, Appleton North. Now, look, today that you know they started the seniors, so it's a little bit of a not typical of what you see from them in terms of the lineup, mm-hmm. I guess I could say, from start to finish. So you always got to put that in here. But, hey, you got to give credit to Neenah for withstanding a bit of a comeback from Appleton North. Brett, what is it now, 13 of 14?
Yeah.
No matter how you slice that, no matter how you look at the opponents, that is an impressive, impressive run by the Rockets. Now, listen, anything can happen in the postseason, right? We've seen it happen. No reason to think that either of these teams couldn't make a nice run. We saw Neenah make it to the state tournament. I don't know if anyone thought they would last year, right? And then you saw Appleton North make it to sectionals. That was a little bit of a surprise as well, Brett. Anything is possible. It's a new season. It all starts on Tuesday, Brett. So I'm looking forward to seeing where these two teams end up.
I am too, but boy, you talk about Neenah. That's a dangerous team right now, isn't it? But I still say this Appleton North team is dangerous too if they can get that three-point shooting and get in that rhythm again offensively, because we've seen them explode offensively this season. They're just definitely in a cold spell right now.
Yeah, they are. And, you know, sometimes it just takes a real hot shooting night to kind of get you out of the schneid, little streak there you got going. So, Brett, I will grab the box, and then I will take off and – I'm wrestling boy over the next 2 days, so we'll see you next week, right?
Sounds good.
Right.
We'll see you for sure. Let me run down the scoring. First for Appleton North, I have Sweeney for two. These are all unofficial. Heckle with two, Ramos with 12, Hardy with four, Kreitzer with five, Gilboat with four, Tamori with seven, Stanislawski with two. For the Rockets, I have Jansen with five, Young with six, Schultz with four, I have Corso with 10, Juckum with seven, and Wunderlich with nine. Oh, and Hosel with two. Those two big free throws right at the end of the game to really secure the win. With the victory, Neenah now finishes its regular season 17-7 overall, 13-5 in the Fox Valley Association. Now winners of nine straight, 13 of 14. Up next for the Rockets, they're home against Eau Claire North on March 1st. WIAA Division I Regional Semifinal tip-off is scheduled for 7 p.m. Appleton North finishes its regular season 16-8 overall, 11-7 in Fox Valley Association play. The Lightning up next for them. Home against Kimberly right here, March 1st again. WIAA Division I Regional Semifinal tip-off also scheduled for 7 p.m. Again, as for us, we'll be somewhere. It's postseason play to be determined, but we'll be streaming boys and girls postseason basketball, and I'll announce our next matchup on my Twitter account, so please give me a follow at PC Bretzi. You can access any of our Game of the Week live streams on our USA Today Network Wisconsin websites. Just go to the sports section and scroll down until you see the Watch Our Varsity Game of the Week Prep live streams link. And again, thank you to our sponsors, CELCOM, ETS Performance, and Cooney's Embroidery and Sportswear. Stay connected to who and what matters most with CELCOM's unlimited data, starting as low as $25 a month per line. Visit CELCOM.com for details. ETS Performance is the leading provider of sports performance training For athletes across the Midwest and Northeast Wisconsin, visit etsperformance.com to schedule your free athlete evaluation today at the ETS location nearest you. And Cooney's, they have the skills and experience to customize your apparel and spread the word about your organization. Contact them today at 920-731-0922 or send them an email at Cooney's, C-O-O-N-E-Y-S 0922 at sbcglobal.net. So for Ricardo, for Rosie, and the entire crew with USA Today Network Wisconsin, this is Brett Christopherson signing off from Appleton North High School. Fox Valley Association regular season finale is in the books. Neenah takes down Appleton.